G'day Estland fan, it's Patrick here, and I'm heading back home. It's about 6:30 right now, so it's getting dark. But you know, before I get home, I'd like to talk to you about a topic that I get asked about pretty often, I have to say, as a pronunciation coach. You know, a lot of learners want to know how to get to native-like pronunciation, right? How could they sound like a native speaker? You know, a lot of scholars, a lot of linguists believe that it's impossible after a certain age. And there's a lot of truth to that. You know, I don't dispute that. I think the older you get, the harder it gets. There's no doubt about that one. But I don't think it's true that you cannot really make it happen after the age of 13. That's what most people in the ESL industry believe. They believe that after the age of 13, it is really impossible for anybody to reach that level of sounding like a native speaker. Well, I'm here to prove him wrong, because I started at the age of 22. And, you know, I've been here for 16 years. And every day, there's no day that goes by, and I mean it, there's no day that goes by without having somebody asking me if I was born in the U.S. And I realize that I don't sound American to every American, you know, on Earth. I realize that. And it's impossible, really, to sound like a native speaker from a certain region, right? Like a local, very local place. It's impossible. I mean, if I've never been to New York, there's no way on earth that I'm gonna sound like a pure New Yorkan to every New Yorkan, right? But I might sound like a New Yorkan to somebody in Texas, right? And vice versa. I might be in New York and I might be speaking English, and you know, they might think that I'm from Texas. So what I'm saying is, it's not possible for somebody who's never been in this particular specific region to sound like somebody who was born in that specific region. So because I've never been there, I mean, it's impossible, right? But I do sound like a native speaker. Now, when you say native speaker, this is a very tricky area here, because, you know, I mean, what is a native speaker? A native speaker of English is a speaker of English that was born in an English-speaking country. So if an American person thinks I was born in Canada, I sound like a native speaker. Whether they like it or not, I sound like a native speaker. If I'm in Australia, and that's where I am, I live in Australia, if Australians born here ask me whereabouts in the U.S. I was born, then, well, I must sound like a native speaker, whether they like it or not. So that's what I'm talking about. And that's not impossible to achieve after the age of 13. So I was 22, and I had to practice intensively. I mean, it took a lot of time. Guys, you gotta put a lot of time into it. It doesn't come easy. I mean, you gotta be obsessed with it. I was obsessed with it, right? Needless to say, I was obsessed with it. I mean, that's what I did all day long. I practiced over 6 hours every day, repeating, you know, watching my mouth movements. You know, I did another clip basically on that subject. You can check it out. But now I'd like to give you 6 steps, you know, very important steps to achieve that level. If you're interested in that, if that's what you want, if that's your goal, if that's what you aspire to, then I'm giving you 6 steps to help you to achieve that level. And I'm gonna start with step one. Step one is learning the IPA. IPA are International Phonetic Alphabet. Okay, and those are the funny symbols that you find in the dictionary when you look up a word that you don't know. The purpose of those IPAs is to help you know what a word sounds like. All right, because in English, spelling is inconsistent. It cannot be relied on. So you cannot really tell what a word sounds like just by looking at it. Okay, that's what I mean. So there's a big gap between spelling and sound, and you can bridge that gap. You can bridge that gap by learning the IPA. All right. So when you come across a word in a book you're reading, or in a show that you're watching on TV, or in a movie, or whatever, you can grab your dictionary. You can look up that word, and if you know IPA, you can read that IPA, and you know what that word sounds like. You don't have to know it. You know, you don't have to know the spelling. You can just simply read the sound symbols. Okay. So that's step number one. Step number two is researching your pronunciation problems. Because if you start the process, you know, if you start your learning process without really understanding what your mistakes are or what your problems are, you're going to be going into this blind. You know, you're going to be walking in the dark. So you've got to know what your problems are so you know what to look for. Okay, that's going to be helpful for step three. Step three is you pick a text and you record it and you listen to yourself and then you correct yourself. But so you're not going to be able to correct yourself if you don't know what your problems are. So if you research your problems, back to step two, if you research your problems and if you learn that R is a big issue for you, then at least you can record yourself and just really focus on the sound R, because you know the sound R is a problem sound. So you focus on it, you target the sound R. Research will help you do that. And then when you record yourself and listen to yourself and correct yourself, you're gonna be able to more effectively correct yourself, right? So that's what the purpose is from doing research and then moving on to step three. Step four, guys, step four is picking a tongue twister, right? So if you pick a tongue twister, you are focusing again on a certain sound. So if you know that you have a problem with the R, you know, back to R, if you got a problem with the sound R, you're gonna pick a tongue twister that features the sound R. So that means you go on Google, and what you do is you find a tongue twister that features the R sound, and that you master that tongue twister. You keep repeating that tongue twister every day, and I know it's boring, but you gotta stick to it until you're able to really make a breakthrough. So that's what you gotta do with step four. Step five is interesting, and I like that step. You know, you need to pick a person, whether it's an actor or a politician or a singer or whatever it may be. You gotta pick a person that you like listening to. You know, you gotta enjoy listening to that person and try to mimic the way they speak. All right, if you try to listen to so many people at the same time, you're gonna get lost. You're gonna be confused, because you know everybody has a different way of talking, right? They have different style, they have different intonation, they have different mannerism. And the point is for you to focus on one person. You gotta really, you gotta be able to predict the pattern of their pattern of speech, right? So they got a certain speech pattern, and by listening to that person repeatedly, you're gonna be able to predict their speech pattern, and you're gonna get better at adjusting yourself to it. And that's the skill that I'd like you to acquire. That's the skill that I'd like you to pick up. I'd like you to learn how to mimic, how to adjust your intonation to their intonation, adjust the music to their music. That's the kind of skill that I'd like you to acquire. And that's what you can do really by listening to one person that you enjoy listening to. So step four, guys, is very important. Step five is very important. Step six is the most important, and I think people, you know, don't take it as seriously, but I think you should really take it seriously. Step six is divorcing the old you. Okay, I know that sounds drastic, It sounds a bit more extreme than other steps, but trust me. Now, don't go denouncing your citizenship just as yet. Don't go renouncing who you are and renouncing, you know, what you stand for as a person. Don't think that I'm encouraging you to forget about your parents and, you know, forget about your friends and forget about your past life. That's not what I'm saying. Don't take me out of context. But look, you've got to be ready to embrace the new version of you, right? Because you're gonna sound different, and you have to be ready to sound different. You gotta embrace that. You have to learn how to use a different voice. You have to accept the fact. You gotta be willing to accept the fact that you're not gonna sound the same person you are. Okay, you've gotta be ready for change. You know, gosh, I mean, the reward is great, guys. I mean, the reward is great if you get to that level. You know, when people think that you're born in an English-speaking country, just imagine what you can do. Just imagine what you can do. Imagine the opportunities with you speaking two languages and you being able to shift from one language to another, you know, effortlessly without even trying hard. I mean, can you imagine how incredibly impressive that is? I mean, it's incredibly impressive. And that's it. I mean, that's all I have to say about it. So we basically went through six steps. And just to recap them, step one is basically learning the IPA. Step two is researching your pronunciation problems, you know, specific to your nationality, specific to your linguistic background. Number three is recording yourself and listening to yourself and correcting yourself. Step number four is picking a tongue twister and practicing a tongue twister. Number five is picking a person that you like to listen to repeatedly and try to mimic. And the last step is divorcing your old self and be prepared to accept to sound different. Okay, so those are six essential and crucial tips or steps that you need to take if you want to sound different, if you want to sound like a native speaker of English. So if you like that clip, like it, please like the clip, share it, and subscribe, all right? Words on Wheels, that's Words on Wheels, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for watching the clip. Look after yourselves, and see you next week.